presenting Lionel for 1992. The traditional line offers Bugs and Daffy, three new sets, new die-cast steamers and diesels, a lineup of colorful rolling stock, which includes many favorites from the past, and handsome new accessories, which will bring action and excitement to your layout. Let's start with the sets. Traditional line sets include everything you need to build your first layout or expand your existing railroad empire. Coastal Limited includes a die-cast locomotive, which features operating smokestack and headlight, a C&O boxcar, Burlington gondola, and Chesapeake and Ohio caboose. The cars feature metal wheels and axles and operating knuckle couplers. The set also includes track, transformer, a new grade crossing, a rugged die-cast metal truck and trailer rig, and over 40 load items. Relive the magic of the Katy Railroad with Lionel's new High Plains Runner. The MKT-442 die-cast steamer features operating smokestack and headlight. The set includes a Sunoil two-dome tank, boxcar, hopper, depressed center car with cable reels, and a square window caboose, all with MKT markings. Cars feature operating knuckle couplers and metal wheels and axles. The set includes transformer, track, 90-degree crossover, die-cast tractor with flatbed trailer, U-grade crossing, a snap-together bridge, and over 40 load items for the trailer. The Louisville and Nashville Railroad earned its keep by hauling coal, which the locals called Black Magic, out of the Appalachian Mountain region. Lionel salutes this legendary road by presenting the Louisville and Nashville Express. The set is headed by an L&N GP38, which features powerful dual motors, diesel horn, eight-wheel drive, and operating headlight. The big six-car consist includes an REA express reefer, L&N boxcar with 9,700 markings, an L&N flatbed with removable trailer, L&N gondola with removable coil covers, L&N hopper with opening hatches, and an L&N square window caboose with illuminated interior and operating smokestack. The rolling stock features operating knuckle couplers and metal wheels and axles. This superset also includes a transformer, track, including a remote uncoupling track section, and a manually operated right-hand switch. Also included is an illuminated bumper, a new grade crossing, and a die-cast metal tractor. The 442 Texas and Pacific die-cast locomotive features headlight and operating smokestack. Illuminated Texas and Pacific square window caboose with operating knuckle couplers is available for separate sale. Another die-cast powerhouse, the 262 Delaware and Hudson. Operating smokestack and headlight and six-wheel drive with traction tire. There's a striking Delaware and Hudson caboose, too, available for separate sale. The caboose features operating knuckle couplers and illuminated interior. The Chicago and Northwestern GP38-2 is a fine runner and terrific puller. The handsome diesel has diesel horn, eight-wheel drive with traction tire, operating knuckle couplers, dual headlights, and illuminated number board. The Chicago and Northwestern bay window caboose. It's illuminated with operating knuckle couplers. Lionel brings back a favorite from the 50s. General Electric 44-tonner in a new road name, the Pennsylvania Railroad. Stamped metal frame, plastic handrails, operating knuckle couplers, operating diesel horn, headlights, and traction tires. Bugs Bunny, Daffy Duck, Looney Tunes.
What's up, Doc?
Lighten up with a little Bugs Bunny and Daffy Duck handcuff.
And that's not all, folks.
Add to your consist of freight and passenger cars with Lionel's new traditional line rolling stock. Each piece is exquisitely detailed and designed to look just like its real-life counterpart. The cars feature operating knuckle couplers, metal wheels and axles, and needlepoint bearing. Increase your intermodal capacity with Lionel's impressive new Southern Pacific TTUX car. For 1992, Lionel brings back an old favorite, the condenser car. First introduced in 1958, this version sports attractive new colors. The Transformer car features New York Central markings. The Cruise missile car features a removable missile with wings that fold out and authentic decals. The MKT three-dome tank car has metal handrails. Lionel's new and improved liquefied gas car comes with removable bulkheads, metal end caps, and a new plastic tank. Two new auto carriers, styled after the carriers in action on the rails today, the Burlington Northern and Union Pacific. Cars have sliding end doors and screened sides. The Union Pacific four-bay hopper comes with operating hatches. New York Central tool car with illuminated interior. And two gondolas with coil covers, CSX and Burlington. Gondola covers have metal handrails. The Ontario Northland flat car with a simulated pulpwood load, die-cast metal sprung trucks, operating knuckle couplers. Operating cars always add realism and action to any layout. Lionel has a fine lineup for 1992. Two boxcars with rail sounds, a Lionel exclusive. The REA boxcar has steam rail sounds, and the New York Central pacemaker has diesel rail sounds. Both cars feature die-cast sprung trucks and come with a sound activation button to trigger the rail sounds. Lionel brings back an old favorite, the flat car with submarine. Submarine can be detached and used separately, and the car features die-cast metal sprung trucks. Here's more fun for Lionel's circus train, the circus clown car. Goofy clowns bob up and down as the car rolls along the track. And the radar car is back. The antenna continually rotates while your train is in motion. The famous Inventor series salutes two toy train giants, Joshua Lionel Cowan and A.C. Gilbert. These cars will be the last in this series. Our famous named boxcar series features attractive graphics, opening doors, operating knuckle couplers, and metal wheels and axles. The Chicago, Illinois, and Midland, Kansas City Southern, and two double-door boxcars, the Toronto, Hamilton, and Buffalo, and the Great Northern. Three new diners complete three popular passenger trains. Cars are illuminated and have operating knuckle couplers, metal wheels and axles, and needlepoint bearings. Northern Pacific, Amtrak, and Illinois Central. Five new die-cast 18-wheelers will make handsome additions to the motor transport division of your layout. And these new intermodal containers provide real-looking loads for your flat cars. Add action and excitement to your layout with these new operating accessories. The animated forklift loader station simulates loading a boxcar with pipes. Grab a cup of coffee at the Lionel Chat and Chew illuminated roadside diner with operating smokestack and exterior lights. And the new Lionel animated billboard offers two message displays. the Lionel Collector line for 1992. Lionel has created a fine model of the American Locomotive Company's loco, which was introduced in 1926. First delivered to the Northern Pacific Railroad, the 484 type came to be synonymous with the road, and subsequently was known as Northern Pacific type, or simply as Northerns. The Lionel model has a die-cast metal cab, magnet traction, constant voltage headlight, operating smokestack and steam chest, and firebox blower. Steam rail sounds, a Lionel exclusive, are in the die-cast tender. Tender also has a backup light, die-cast trucks, and an operating knuckle coupler. A standard O square window caboose goes with the Northern. The caboose features die-cast trucks, illumination, smoke, opening toolboxes, and two operating couplers. Lionel proudly announces the addition of the Western Maryland Shea locomotive to its growing stable of highly detailed, prototypical locomotives. This radically designed locomotive features die-cast metal body, die-cast metal trucks and operating knuckle couplers, metal wheels and axles, traction tires, brass and steel detailing, operating valves and drive rods, Shea rail sounds, operating smokestack, directional headlight and backup light, firebox glow, and two railroad figures. Last year, Lionel introduced a beautiful set of Lackawanna multiple-unit commuter cars. For 1992, Lionel has added a non-powered coach and combine car. Together, these cars create a truly impressive concept. Introducing a proud new road name to the fleet of Lionel commuter cars, the Pennsylvania Railroad. This two-unit set includes a powered combine car with two powerful motors and a non-powered coach. Features include die-cast metal trucks, direction headlights on both units, metal chains at both ends, operating red marker lights, illuminated interiors, and passenger silhouettes in the windows. Many railroad buffs consider the Alco PA to be the most beautifully designed diesel locomotive ever made. And the all-new Lionel model, in the colors of the Denver and Rio Grande, has a masterful replica of this famous diesel locomotive. The new Lionel Alco PA comes in an ABA combination. The powered A unit features die-cast metal frame, die-cast metal trucks, die-cast metal operating knuckle coupler on the nose end, and a non-operating knuckle coupler on the rear. Metal wheels and axles, traction tires, metal grills, fan detail, operating Mars light, constant lighting system, opening cab doors, detailed cab interior, engineer figure, and two powerful motors which run on AC or DC current. The non-powered PA1 unit features die-cast metal frame, die-cast metal trucks, die-cast metal operating knuckle coupler on the nose end, and a non-operating coupler on the rear, metal wheels and axles, metal grills, fan detail, diesel rail sounds, operating Mars light, constant lighting system, opening cab doors, detailed cab interior, and engineer figure. The non-powered PB1 unit features stamped metal frame, die-cast metal trucks, die-cast non-operating knuckle couplers on both ends, metal wheels and axles, metal grills, fan detail, and opening cab door. The most popular type of loco with a trailing truck ever built in the United States was the 282 Mikado. Over 10,000 were built by all three major builders, Baldwin, Lima, and American Locomotive Company. The Southern Railroad purchased its first Mikado in 1921. It was numbered 4501. The Lionel model is prototypically correct right down to the number. Other features include operating smokestack, headlight, firebox glow, and illuminated marker lights. The tender features authentic steam rail sounds and backup light. The Southern Standard O square window caboose features die-cast trucks, operating smokestack, opening toolboxes, operating knuckle couplers, and flashing warning light. Mud cars have been a Lionel tradition since 1956. The tradition continues with the introduction of a Canadian Pacific powered coach and non-powered baggage car. The coach features a powerful AC Pullmore motor, die-cast trucks, operating knuckle couplers, operating headlights, magnet traction, illuminated interior, and chain detail. The non-powered baggage car features operating knuckle couplers, working headlights, chain detail, and illuminated interior. The phrase "fallen flags" was first used by Trains Magazine as a tribute to railroads no longer in existence. Lionel honors these ghosts of the rails with their Fallen Flag series. Introducing Fallen Flags number 6, the Nickel Plate Road. To commemorate the first two diesels used by the Nickel Plate Road, Lionel presents twin GP7s with rail sounds, die-cast trucks, metal chassis and handrails, operating knuckle couplers, and working headlights. Fallen Flags number 6 rolling stock, available for separate sale, feature six handsome, highly detailed cars, all worthy of the proud nickel plate tradition. All the cars feature die-cast sprung trucks and operating knuckle couplers. The nickel plate caboose features opening toolboxes, illuminated interior, flashing rear warning light, and operating smokestack. The Southern Pacific Railroad is known for its gorgeous steamers. In 1983, Lionel introduced the GS4, and in 1991, the GS2. And for 1992, by popular demand, Lionel proudly introduces Madison-type passenger cars to match those beautiful engines. The individual sale four-car consist includes three Pullman coaches, the Arcata Bay, Half Moon Bay, and Drake's Bay, and the Sunset Bay observation car. And to go with the mighty Redding T1, the Lionel Madison cars in Redding Railroad markings. Also available for a separate sale, the four cars consist of a baggage, two coaches, and an observation car. Lionel Madison cars feature spring-loaded doors, die-cast trucks, authentic undercarriage detail, and operating knuckle couplers. A Southern Pacific GS steamer and a Redding T1. Together with Lionel's legendary Madison cars, two magnificent trains. Announcing the 1992 Service Station Special. The Western Pacific Railroad, famed for both freight and passenger trains, became known as the route of the Feather River because the road got its start in the Feather River Canyon, a beautiful spot in the Sierra Nevada mountain range. Lionel proudly pays tribute to this famous line with the Feather River Service Station Special Set. The set is headed by a Western Pacific GP9. The diesel engine features stamped metal chassis and handrails, operating knuckle couplers at both ends, metal wheels and axles, eight-wheel drive, operating diesel horn, dual operating headlights, and two powerful motors, which will run on AC or DC current. The authentic freight cars feature die-cast sprung trucks, operating knuckle couplers, and metal wheels and axles. Features an operating smokestack, warning light, opening toolboxes, and illuminated interior. Introducing the Norfolk Southern Unit Train. five Norfolk Southern flat cars with trailers and an extended vision NS caboose are headed by a striking Dash 8 40C diesel engine. The Dash 8 features die-cast metal trucks, die-cast operating knuckle couplers, metal wheels and axles, 12-wheel drive, magna traction, detailed brake lines, snowplow, handrails, diesel horn, operating headlights, flashing warning light, illuminated cab and number boards, engineer figure, and powerful twin Pullmore motors. The flat cars feature die-cast sprung trucks, die-cast metal operating couplers, metal wheels and axles, trailers with removable die-cast metal frames, and fifth-wheel stanchion and chocks. The caboose features die-cast metal trucks, die-cast operating knuckle couplers, operating smokestack, and illuminated interior. The Lionel Collector Line rolling stock for 1992 features favorites from the past, as well as the latest in rail hardware. Add to your 1991 Frisco Fallen Flag Train with a legendary six-wheel crane car and flat car with stakes. The crane car has six-wheel die-cast trucks, operating knuckle couplers, metal crank, and a metal hook that goes up and down when you turn the crank. The new 14-stake flat car, a fine car by itself or paired with the crane, comes with die-cast sprung trucks and operating knuckle couplers. Another old favorite, the Searchlight Caboose, features die-cast trucks, operating searchlight, and operating smokestack with New York Central markings. The Wabash Bunk Car with operating smokestack features die-cast sprung trucks, operating knuckle couplers, and illuminated interior. The operating brakeman car returns with die-cast trucks, operating knuckle couplers, two telltales, a brakeman figure, and all the familiar action. Two ore cars are new, the Pennsylvania and Bessemer and Lake Erie. The cars feature ore loads, die-cast sprung trucks, operating knuckle couplers, and metal wheels and axles. Four new Standard O cars live up to the high standards Lionel has established for this popular series. Standard O rolling stock features die-cast sprung trucks, metal wheels and axles, and operating knuckle couplers. New for 1992 are two center flow hoppers, the two-bay Cargill and the three-bay Erie Lackawanna, and two double-door boxcars, the Chicago and Illinois Midland and the Union Pacific. I-beam flat cars are used on the real railroads to haul plywood. Lionel's new scale-sized models of these impressive cars are 20 inches long and come with 24 stacks of simulated plywood with functional cable tie-downs. You've seen unibody tank cars on the real railroads. Now you can have them on your layout. Introducing the Texaco and Archer Daniels Midland unibody tank cars. The Lionel three-bay hopper features six opening bay hatches and a simulated coal load. Two new road names, Lehigh Valley and Peabody. First cataloged in 1940, Lionel's semi-scale freight cars became the accepted freight complement for the semi-scale Hudson and Switcher locomotives, presenting two all-new designs for this superior line of freight cars. Lackawanna Reefer, and Chesapeake and Ohio stock car. Both cars feature a die-cast metal frame, heavy phenolic body, die-cast metal trucks, operating knuckle couplers, and opening doors on each side. Presenting one of the most famous and beautiful trains ever to grace the rails of North America, the Great Northern Empire Builder. The five-car set is headed by Lionel's legendary F3-ABA combination. The A units feature working headlights, illuminated number boards, die-cast metal F3 trucks, metal ladders, portholes, two-piece horns, screened vents, and operating knuckle couplers. Power comes from twin Pullmore motors with eight-wheel drive and magna traction. This beautiful ABA combination also features rail sounds. The handsome, smooth-sided passenger cars feature illuminated interiors and have die-cast metal trucks and couplers. Put more action in your layout with these great new accessories. Animated freight station. One workman pushes a two-wheeler, another pulls freight up the ramp, and a third workman waits his turn. The Lionel Steam Clean and Wheel Grinding Shop simulates vital functions necessary to every railroad. Wheel grinding, steam cleaning, and a wash job complete with spinning brushes. Also included is a warning strobe signal and siren. This highly detailed accessory will add plenty of action, sounds, and lights to any layout. The Lionel Lift Bridge. Ultra-smooth lifting system. Massive counterweights. Realistic rivet detail. Manually activated bells and horn sounds. Strobe lights on top of the towers. A control panel and its own power supply. The new Lionel Lift Bridge may be the most impressive and finely detailed accessory ever offered. Red and green signal lights warn river and rail traffic when the bridge is down and when the bridge is being raised. Fail-safe sensors assure the trains will not go over the edge when the bridge is up. Available now. American Flyer for 1992. In 1956, American Flyer introduced the Northern Pacific Vista Dome North Coast Limited. This was the first in a series of passenger sets, headed by American Flyer's fine model of the Alco PA Diesel, which had become prized by collectors. Lionel is proud to bring back this toy train legend. The ABA combination features operating knuckle couplers, die-cast trucks, metal chassis, and metal steps. The powered unit features dual motors with eight-wheel drive. The matching cars feature illuminated interiors with die-cast trucks, needle-point axles, and operating knuckle couplers. A first, rail sounds come to American Flyer. Listen. Add this new PB1 non-powered engine to your Vista Dome North Coast Limited, and you will have the latest in S-gauge beauty and realism. Another matching Pullman is also available for separate sale. With these additions, the North Coast Limited becomes a magnificent ABBA six-car set. Another famous locomotive which traveled the rugged terrain of the Pacific Northwest was the Milwaukee Road's Little Joe. Never before offered by American Flyer, we are proud to introduce a fine new model of this famous locomotive. Powered by a powerful long-life motor with four-wheel drive, the engine features operating pantographs, headlights, horn, and operating knuckle couplers. An old American Flyer favorite returns for 1992, the animated caboose, featuring an all-new brakeman figure and colorful Milwaukee Road markings. It's the perfect complement for the Milwaukee Road's Little Joe. More favorites from the past, all with the latest engineering advances. Two boxcars, the Missouri Pacific and the Bangor and Aroostook. Penn Salt single dome tank car, and a Domino Sugar covered hopper. The cars feature die-cast metal trucks and operating knuckle couplers. When there is talk of the most beautiful toy train sets ever made, American Flyer's chrome-plated Mayflower is always among the first sets mentioned. Fewer than 200 of these magnificent sets were made in 1929. Presenting the Mayflower by American Flyer, the ultimate in toy train art. All metal construction, brass trim, illuminated. New 200 series freight cars. the 1-214 boxcar and the 1-215 tank car. Beep, beep. Here comes the Roadrunner and Wile E. Coyote in large scale. Articulated figures, removable tools, heavy-duty DC motor. Now you can add the look of double-headed power to your Burlington Northern GP20. Introducing a Burlington Northern GP20 non-powered engine. Operating knuckle couplers, engineer figure, flashing warning light, dual headlights.
Lionel Tour, the making of the Scale Hudson. Tour the Lionel factory and follow the making of the greatest engine of them all, the Scale Hudson. You'll see everything involved in the manufacturing process: planning, engineering, assembly, decoration, advertising. Behind the scenes, 40 minutes, color, VHS only.
We hope you enjoyed our presentation. For more information about Lionel Trains for 1992, see your dealer. Thanks for watching.